Valence bond theory. Now, for simple diatomic molecules, the valence bond theory correctly predicts the overlap of electrons found in the pure atomic orbitals. However, in most cases, the pure atomic orbitals do not have the correct energies or orientations to accurately predict the observed molecular geometries. Rather, typically, according to the valence bond theory, when an atom is bound to another atom within a molecule, the atom can combine its own valence shell electrons to create new hybridized orbitals that have lower energy than the pure atomic valence orbitals, and with their shapes, correctly predict the experimentally determined molecular geometries. Let's take a look at the example for methane. Methane, the formula is CH4. The Lewis structure predicts four bonds, four regions of high electron density, and four single bonds. The Vesper model and the geometry of methane is tetrahedral. So if we think of the pure atomic orbitals that exist on the atoms in this molecule, for hydrogen, of course, the atomic orbital is just 1s1. It's just a sphere with one electron. However, for carbon, the valence shell electron configuration is 2s2, 2p2. All right, so if we think of the carbon atom, the hydrogen atom with each one electron, the atomic orbitals are just fine. But if they approach down some axes, the axis of the covalent bond, carbon, the 2s orbital of carbon is full, if it's as the pure atomic orbital predicts. And the 2p, there's two p's, one would be down, let's say, one axis, if there's an axis here, and another one would be perpendicular down another axis. All right, so if we had one electron here and one electron in this p orbital, there's no 90 degree angles in the methane molecule. So in order to predict, and this is mathematically supported by the valence bond theory, what happens is that the pure atomic orbitals on the carbon atom hybridize or mix. And so we have a 2s and three 2p orbitals available. And what happens in the case of methane, it's correctly predicted by the valence bond theory, is that there's new atomic orbitals that are made that are combinations of the old orbitals. And the new ones are called the hybrid orbitals. And we combine the 1s and the 3p's to form four new hybrid orbitals, each called sp3. And this is the pattern that occurs in the valence bond theory. The number of individual pure atomic orbitals, whatever the total number of orbitals that combine, you end up with that total number of new orbitals. So we have the s and the 3p's combining to give four. Four individual atomic orbitals produce four new, equally matched in shape and energy atomic orbitals that are now hybridized. So these orbitals are localized still on the carbon, but they are now equally matched atomic hybridized orbitals. And the shape of the new orbital is a linear combination of the shapes of the four individual atomic orbitals. So these new orbitals, 25% of them will have the S character, and 75% of the shape comes from the P character. So it looks like kind of a strange dumbbell with one side inflated. And these arrange themselves around the nucleus, and they are in the shape of the tetrahedron. And so this is the new hybridization. And this is favorable because if you look at the energy level of the individual 2s and the 2p, of course the 2p is higher in energy, And then after the hybridization occurs, the new orbitals are all degenerate. They're all of the same energy. And that energy is in intermediate between the lower energy of the S and the higher energy of the P. Okay, so we can think then now in the case of the methane, what happens is there's four valence electrons. They were originally two in the 2s and two in the 2p. They fall out into this degenerate four sp3 orbitals. This is an sp3, this is an sp3, this is an sp3, and this is an sp3. Each one of them are called sp3 orbitals. I need to tell you that this little superscript here doesn't indicate the number of electrons. It's part of the name, meaning that this new hybridized orbital was created from 1s and 3p's. So the 3 indicates the number of p's orbitals that were combined to give the new orbitals. Anyway, so we have the four new orbitals, and they correctly predict the geometry that we see. We have a head-on overlap. If you have an axis right down through here, you have a head-on overlap from the hydrogen, the 1s electron in the hydrogen, and then the sp3 electron in this orbital, and then back here in this one, back here in this one, and then behind the molecule, you can't even see it, but there's another one with a head-on overlap with this. So we can correctly predict the tetrahedral geometry for this. You can correctly predict the tetrahedral geometry using these hybrid orbitals. So a hybrid orbital is a mixing of the pure atomic orbitals. Hybrid orbitals are still atomic orbitals. They're found on the carbon, but they no longer have the same location and energy and orientation as the pure s, but now their orientation is such that it explains the observed electronic and molecular geometry of the individual molecule.